You have finally installed your Linux from a bootable USB flash drive. You enjoy using it. But there is an unexpected problem. Something happened to your flash drive. You try to format it, but you keep getting errors. The flash drive just misbehaves, and you don't know what to do. Don't get upset. This video will show you how to restore it to normal. Hello everyone, it's a Rich Linux user, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. So you have installed Linux using a bootable USB flash drive, and after that, your flash drive doesn't work or works incorrectly. For example, you copied some files there and they disappear, or you can connect your flash drive to Linux, but it doesn't work on Windows. So let's fix that problem. To show you where the problem is, I will open GNOME Disk Utility. You can use any other partition manager. For example, you can use KDE Partition Manager, or you can use command line utilities. So in Linux Mint and Ubuntu, GNOME Disk Utility is simply called disk. And here in the left panel, I can see all my hard drives. And this is my flash drive, 16 gigs Samsung flash drive, which I have just used as a bootable USB flash drive to install Ubuntu. You can see here that Ubuntu image is written here, and this is where the problem is. Because as you can see, this is a flash drive, and normally it should have just one partition. But when you write an ISO image to your flash drive, it creates several partitions which are coded in the ISO image. For example, in case of Ubuntu, there are two partitions here, and then there is some free space left. This is not a normal configuration of a flash drive, that's why it's not recognized by many systems, or it is recognized incorrectly. Because it's a bootable USB flash drive, it has a bootable flag here. So many systems will just see this flash drive as a drive with a bootable system, not just as a flash drive to store information. I don't know all the technical details here, but when you write an ISO to a flash drive, it also changes the file system identification of your flash drive. So that's why even if you format it, it may still not work correctly. For example, if I try to remove these partitions using this GNOME Disk Utility, it will not work. So I click here to remove this partition, but I get this error, the partition cannot be removed. So this may seem like a big problem, but don't worry, it can be fixed very easily. You just need to run one simple command in the terminal and reformat your flash drive. But before we start doing that, I would like to remind you that in Linux, all the hard drives have a specific name assigned to it. So my flash drive has the name SDB, because it was mounted second on this system. If I go to my main hard drive, I can see that it has name SDA, because it's a main system drive, so it was mounted first and it was assigned the letter A. But the flash drive was mounted second, so it has the letter B. Depending on how many drives you have in your system, your flash drive name can differ, so it's very important to remember the name of your flash drive. It is SDB in my case. You can check this name in the command line too. You just need to type the command sudo fdisk with option L. When you type your password in the terminal, you see nothing, you just need to type it and press enter. And here you can see all the partitions of your system. And you need to find your flash drive based on its size. For example, I know that my flash drive is 15 gigs, so it has the name SDB, as you can see here. And here is the main system. It has three partitions here. And remember, I mentioned before that a bootable flash drive has this boot flag, which might not be removed if you just simply format your flash drive. So you need to completely wipe the file system from your flash drive to restore it to its original state. So let's do that. I will clean this terminal window. And now you need to type the command to exactly wipe the file system of your flash drive. So you type sudo wipe fs, then you add the option O because we want to remove everything. And then it's very important, you need to type the name of your flash drive, which was dev sdb for my case. So be very careful that you type the name correctly here, because if you wipe the file system of your main hard drive, you may destroy your whole system. So again, double check everything before you press enter here. When you are sure that you type the name of your flash drive correctly, you need to press enter. So the file system has been wiped. Now our flash drive is completely clean. If you run the command sudo fdisk with option L again, You can see that this is our flash drive, and there is no file system here, so there are no any partitions here. Therefore, we need to create a new partition. And it depends what you prefer. You can stay in this terminal and use the command line to create a new partition table. But you can also use graphical programs. So let's first do the command line way, and then I will show you how you can do the same with a graphical program. To create a new partition table from the command line, you can use this simple utility, which is called cfdisk. And you need to type the name of your flash drive, which is sdb. For the flash drive, you select DOS type, then you press enter to create new partition. So by default, it suggests to create the maximum possible partition. This is what we want for a flash drive. You make it primary. Then you need to select write. Here you confirm that you want to create a new partition table. And the new partition table has been created. Now you can quit. Next, we need to format this partition. So you type sudo, then you type make filesystem vfat. If you want, you can also add any label to your flash drive. I will call it as average Linux user flash drive. And then you specify the partition name here. Again, it's the name of our flash drive, which is sdb. And here we need to add the number 1, because we have one partition on this flash drive. And you press enter. Now the flash drive is formatted and it's ready to use. For example, if you open the file manager, you can see that our new flash drive can be mounted and you can write information into it. But I also promised to show you how to create a partition table and reformat your flash drive with a graphical program. So let's clean our flash drive again and reformat it with gparted. First we need to unmount it, because we mounted it with a file manager. And we clean it. So now when our flash drive is cleaned, we open gparted. If you don't have gparted on your system, you can install it. It should be available in any Linux system. Just search for it in your software manager. And here in the corner you need to select your flash drive, which is sdb in my case. And you see there is no allocated space here. So you go to device and create a new partition table. Again, we select MS-DOS here, as we have done from the command line. And then you can create a new partition here. We will use a maximum space here. For the file system, it's better to use FAT file system, because it is compatible for any system, if you want to use it with Windows, for example. And you can give it a label here. You can just use your name, for example. Then you click add, and this is the plan what we're gonna do, but the changes have not been applied yet. So you just need to click on this icon and apply all the changes. It will take some time to reformat the flash drive. Everything has finished successfully. Now your flash drive is ready for use. You open file manager, and here you can see in the devices our flash drive, which again can be used to write any information here. Finally, I would like to mention that if the procedure I have just shown didn't work for you and your flash drive is still not recognized by your system or doesn't work correctly, there is one last thing which you can try. So you need to open the terminal again, make sure that your flash drive is not mounted, so you run the command sudo umount and your flash drive. Again, sdb is the name of my flash drive and it has one partition, which is partition 1. So I check that it's not mounted. And after that, you can completely overwrite all the blocks of your flash drive with zeros. This will be kind of complete refreshment of your flash drive. So you type the command sudo dd with option if, and you specify to generate zeros. And with the option off, you specify the name of your flash drive. And if before we used sdb1, it was a partition name, but the name of the flash drive is sdb, so you don't need to specify any number here. So, but before you press enter, make sure that this is the name of your flash drive. Because this action will destroy all the information on your flash drive, so if you accidentally specified here the name of the hard drive where you store your important files, or you specify the hard drive with your system, it will completely destroy it, and the files will be lost forever. So before you run it, be very, very careful that this is the name of your flash drive. When you are sure that everything is fine and this is the name of your flash drive, you can press Enter. Writing zeros to a flash drive takes quite a lot of time, and if your flash drive is big, it takes really long time, so you just need to wait. But I will speed up this video to save some time. So when everything is finished successfully and there were no errors, you can create a new partition table on your flash drive and format it with FAT file system. Again, you can use cfdisk utility if you prefer the command line, or you can open gpartit and do everything with the graphical interface. And hopefully after that your flash drive will be working as a new one. But even if this didn't help, I think your flash drive is dead and you need to buy a new one. Now you know how to recover your bootable USB flash drive to its normal state. But you can use this method to recover any other USB flash drive which stopped working or doesn't work correctly. Most likely you will be able to restore this flash drive to its normal state and it will start working as a new. Thank you for watching!